Welcome back to Virginia This Morning. Our next guest enjoyed success as a 1970s child star for her role as Dee Thomas on the hit sitcom What's Happening. She's now a published author and a successful veterinarian in our area and shares pet tips with our viewers.
That's right. Dr. Danielle's memorabilia as Dee Thomas will be featured in the permanent collection of the Smithsonian's National Museum of African American History and Culture. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That had to be just huge.
It is, and I'm still like in a daze from it all. I mean, it was just so exciting. And also to meet all of the other people and all of their contributions, I mean, that museum is absolutely gorgeous.
Now, you have some items as well. You're not just being honored, but you have a script and T-shirt and other
right.
things
and
part of this
book.
Permanent collection as well.
It's unbelievable. I seriously cannot even digest it. I mean, first of all, that the show is remembered from 40 years ago, but then also to be featured, you know, in this museum, along with other shows that have been trailblazers. And so I'm really excited that, you know, all of our items will be there permanently.
You were a little girl when this whole thing got started on the show, and
it
stole so many hearts, and people just loved you and everything. Can we focus on your parents and the role they played in all of this? Because it's
absolutely.
Huge.
Absolutely. I mean, my mom, you know, has been everything, and also my stepfather, who was the one who introduced me into acting in the first place. And so both he and my mom were definitely instrumental in picking the auditions for me, what I should go out for, and, you know, also getting What's Happening, which was dynamic. That was, I didn't get it originally. And then a month later, I got a phone call and they said, fly out to California, you have the role. And I mean, it was just like my life changed, you know, because I'm originally from New York.
Well, for a little girl, you had a lot of sass. Did you go in? Did that mirror the person that you were off stage?
Well, I used to say it did not because I did not have an older brother. However, I had a lot of like pent up sassiness, you know, because I wanted to be like that. And I had an excuse, so why not?
And getting paid for it as well.
Paid. Exactly.
We have a clip right here. And Tori, can we roll this right here? This is Dee Thomas and What's Happening.
Or a school psychologist. We'll meet with you this afternoon to discuss fourth grade students. Come in.
Is this where I'm supposed to be?
If you're Dee Thomas, it is. I'm Dr. Claymore. Why don't you have a seat and we'll discuss your problem.
Look, first let's get something straight. I'm not here to talk about my problem. I've got no problems. I'm here for a friend.
Oh, sure. I understand.
That's good, because if I had a problem, I'd handle it myself. That's the kind of person I am.
See. Okay, then. What's your friend's name?
A little sass right there with none other than Tim Reed.
Huh? I know.
That guy looked vaguely familiar.
Yeah. Do you stay in touch with some of the cast members?
I do. As a matter of fact, I was just texting Ernest, who played my brother, just a couple of weeks ago. And, you know, he's doing theater and managing and still acting as well.
And Tim Reed, you ended up in the Richmond area.
How about that? We both ended up in the same place. Actually, I'd heard some time ago that he had a fabulous studio here. So it's a great place to be for actors.
Tell us about Miss Mabel, Mom.
Mm-hmm. She, of course, was the light of everyone's life. She was everyone's mom, and she made you immediately feel comfortable. Of course, being a veteran, she was, you know, very easy to go up to her and ask her about tips with acting. But, I mean, she was just like a mom mm-hmm. to all of us.
You mentioned earlier that your stepdad, your mom and your stepdad were instrumental in getting you into the show.
Right.
Then there was a car accident in which basically your stepdad saved your life.
Yeah.
And then the next phase of your life starts, and he was instrumental in that as well.
Well, yeah, in terms of the car accident, I didn't even realize it until I woke up from my coma, but they said that in him reaching over the steering wheel, he ruptured his spleen and his kidney, I believe. So, yeah, so that was really, really unfortunate. But also just, you know, from my work on What's Happening and then them pushing me into it, that I was able to be recognized as being a trailblazer, which mm-hmm.
But did he have something to do with you becoming a veterinarian? Did I hear about that?
No.
He was really interested in that?
No, I've always loved animals. And actually, I met a female veterinarian that really sparked my interest. And, you know, and I thought I could do it because I'm seeing another woman doing it, first of all. And so after I met her, you know, my life changed. And I knew I was going to be a vet after that.
That's fantastic. I understand in 2006, you received an award for the actress that is in most need of a timeout. I wonder why.
I know. I'm like, how mean is that?
But it's all good. All good.
And she's such a sweet lady.
I know. Yeah. Well, Danielle, we just want to say thank you so much for all of the hours of entertainment. And it's still in syndication. And it's such a treat to see you here.
It's me.
Sharing advice for all of our four-legged friends. Thanks so much.
You.
And congratulations.
Well, and we'll look forward to going up to Washington and seeing that.
Yes, you must see it. Yeah. It's beautiful.
Yeah. Hey.